The Dog de Bordeaux, Bordeaux Mastiff, French Mastiff, or just Bordeaux Dog, is a large French Mastiff breed of the Molossoid type and is one of the oldest French dogs. The DDP, as they're sometimes called, are a breed of very muscular and powerful dogs that are known for their massive head, fearless temperament, and powerful body. These loyal, self-assured, and territorial dogs make superb guard dogs, and they also excel in many sports and activities like karting, obedience, therapy work, tracking, and search and rescue. Their loyal, affectionate, and protective nature also makes them devoted family dogs. Intrigued yet? Let's take a look at the list of our top 10 interesting facts about the Dog de Bordeaux. Number 1. Their history. The Dog de Bordeaux's history stretches so far back that it's impossible to pinpoint the breed's exact origins. One theory maintains that the dog is an indigenous French breed developed over thousands of years. On the other hand, other theories name the Mastiff, Neapolitan Mastiff, Tibetan Mastiff, and Greek Mastiff types as possible close ancestors. Either way, the dogs were known in France as early as the 14th century, particularly in southern France and the region around Bordeaux, a port city in southwestern France where the breed gets its name from. They were first exhibited in France in 1863, after which they gained popularity not only in their home country, but in the other parts of the world too. The AKC recognized the breed in 2008. Number 2. They came in two sizes. The present-day male dogs stand 23 to 27 inches tall at the shoulder and weigh a minimum of 110 pounds. Females stand 23 to 26 inches at the shoulder and weigh a minimum of 99 pounds. However, the breed was at one time known to come in two varieties, dogs and Dogwins, the dog being considerably larger than the Dogwin. The smaller Dogwin disappeared from the historical records after the 1700s, leaving the slightly larger version of the breed as we know today as the Dog de Bordeaux. Number 3. They're said to be related to Romans. A prevailing origin tale of the Bordeaux has it that the dog's ancestors were introduced to France, then called Gaul, by Julius Caesar's conquering legions in the 1st century BC. This is because there was a breed similar to Dog de Bordeaux in Rome at the time of Julius Caesar's reign, which was known as the Molossus and was possibly a cousin of the Neapolitan Mastiff. These immense Mastiff types were utilized by the Romans as both war dogs and ferocious gladiators who did battle with other dogs and wild beasts in the arena. Thus, the DDB may have descended from the Molossus, given the fact that the dog shares common links as all modern Molossers. Number 4. They're a highly versatile breed. The Bordeaux is believed to have been used for dog fighting initially. However, they outlived their usefulness as fighting dogs and came to be employed at various times as hunters, drafters, and guarders. They're said to have hunted pigs, boar, wolves, and even bears around the 12th century. During the Middle Ages, they were used to drive cattle, guard flocks, and help soldiers in wars. By the late 1700s, they were used as guard dogs on the nobility's vast estates, although this employment abruptly ended with the French Revolution. Today, Bordeaux are used in a variety of activities like sport, cart pulling, and even therapy work, while many of them find loving homes to live in with their families. Number 5. They were once scarce in number. Between 1969 and 1980, imported dogs in the US were scarce, limited to only a few breeders. The breed was officially introduced to American purebred enthusiasts in an article written in 1982 by the American anthropologist Dr. Carl Simoncic. When the article was published, there were no Dog de Bordeaux in the United States. There were only about 600 of these guys left in the world, mostly in France, the Netherlands, and East Berlin, and the breed's numbers were on the decline as well. Later in 1989, the typical American family saw the Dog de Bordeaux for the first time on the big screen in a movie about a policeman and his canine partner, Turner and Hooch. Since then, the Bordeaux has taken hold in the United States and can be found in greatly increasing numbers across the country. Number 6. Their head is massive. A large head with proper proportions and features is a crucial breed characteristic of the Dog de Bordeaux. These dogs are claimed to have the largest head in the canine world in proportion to the rest of the body. For males, the circumference of the head, measured at the widest point of the skull, is roughly equal to the dog's height at the shoulders. These guys are also brachycephalic, meaning that they have a short nose and a flat face like that of pugs, shih tzus, and chihuahuas. Number 7. They have a calm temperament. Dogs are calm companions who also stay alert for signs of trouble. They exude a natural confidence and do not back down from new activities or dangers. These dogs are very gentle and loving of their family, and they bond strongly with their humans. They're highly protective of their territory and their families. This means that your Bordeaux may show aggression towards strangers and other dogs, so early socialization is also a must for this breed. Number 8. They drool a lot. the Bordeaux drools excessively. You gotta be familiar with strings of drool covering furniture, floors, and walls. So if you want a clean and tidy breed, the DDB is not the one for you. These big canines leave puddles of drool all around the house that you'll have to constantly clean. Their wrinkly and jowly muzzle also tends to be a gathering spot for lots of slobber, adding to their grooming needs. However, if you don't mind having to wipe under your dog's jowls ever so often, you might just find a loving and affectionate companion in your dog. Number 9. Their grooming needs. The main concern when it comes to the grooming needs of the Bordeaux is their drooling. The wrinkles on the facial area need special attention at least weekly, and sometimes daily, to keep them clean and dry. Besides that, it's also important to clean the ears and check for debris or signs of infection every week. Bathing and nail trimming can be done monthly. The coat is low maintenance but sheds throughout the year, so weekly brushing is needed to get rid of any dead hair. Number 10. They have a few health concerns. Larger breeds of canines tend to have shorter life expectancy. The Dog de Bordeaux, being among the larger breeds, lives for about 5 to 6 years. The brachycephalic head of the breed can cause breathing problems or may make your dog intolerant of heat or exercise. It may also result in ectropion, a condition in which the lower eyelids roll outward, which may lead to conjunctivitis or eye inflammation and bacterial infections. These guys are also commonly affected by heart problems like aortic stenosis, a disease in which the aortic valve is narrowed. They're also prone to dilated cardiomyopathy, a condition in which the heart cannot pump the blood efficiently. So paying a regular visit to the vet is the best for your dog's long and healthy life, considering their very short lifespan. Alright guys, that marks the end of our list of top 10 interesting facts about the Dog de Bordeaux. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you already own one of these gentle giants, leave a comment below to let us know about them. Please leave a thumbs up and share the video if you liked it. For more interesting facts and different dog breeds, click on our channel and don't forget to subscribe. See you guys in the next one.